So a different kind of partitioning strategy is known as multi-level graph coarsening. It's a form of divide and conquer. Let's start with a conceptual illustration. You start with an input graph. Pretend this is an input graph. You then replace it with a smaller version. In the graph sense, the coarse graph would have fewer nodes and edges, but would somehow look like the original graph. You might repeat this a few times until you get a version of the graph that is small enough to partition quickly. You then partition the smallest graph. If you've done a good job preserving the relationship between the coarsest graph and its parent graph, then a split in the coarse graph will correspond to a roughly equivalent split in the fine graph. And you'd repeat this reverse step until you have a partition of the original. So that's the concept, but how do you actually coarsen a graph? Most schemes have the following flavor. First, identify at least one subset of the vertices to collapse or to merge. For instance, here's a subset of 5 vertices. I'm going to replace this subset with a single supervertex. Now remember that one of your partitioning goals is to obtain balanced partitions. So it's probably a good idea to track the fact that there were 5 vertices here that became one vertex. An easy way to do that is to assign a weight of 5 to the supervertex. You'll also want to track edge weights so that later on we can cut edges accurately. Let's see how that might work. Consider 2 vertices in a weighted graph. Remember, even if the original graph is unweighted, we repeatedly coarsen by aggregating nodes and edges, and so we'll accumulate weights. In this example, wi is a function that maps every vertex to some weight. Similarly, the function xi will map edges to weights. Now, let's suppose that we join just these 2 vertices into a supervertex. Let's call this new vertex s. Its weight is the sum of the weights of u and v. Now, what about the edge weights? The main case to think about is the following. Suppose there's a vertex t that's connected to both u and v. Then these 2 edges will become a single super edge in the coarsened graph. So what is its weight? A natural idea is simply to sum the weights of the original edges. So the weight of the new edge is just the weight of the 2 old edges that got merged. The reason we do this is so that if we partition or cut this edge in the coarsened graph, we'll know that it maps to 2 edges in the original graph. Now before you move on, it's a good idea to check that this procedure makes sense to you. Okay, let's go back to the original sample graph and see what would happen by applying these rules. Consider this first merge group again. There are 5 vertices which become one supervertex. There are also several cases in which multiple edges should merge. Here's the result. Now let's suppose someone gives us a sequence of merge groups, and let's coarsen the graph accordingly. Coarsen, coarsen. So this is the final result. That's the basic process of coarsening a graph. This final result kind of looks like something. Oink! Do you know about Atlanta's Pink Pig ride?